Hello there. Welcome to Cigar Review TV. I am your host, Damon Pettit. And we're going to be doing Savinelli today. It's a special selection, 2005, Nicaragua. I am at the Point Hilton Tapatio Resort here in Arizona, right outside of Phoenix. It might be actually still in Phoenix, but either way, my old trusty cutter. It's a 100%, well, not 100%, it's a Nicaraguan binder, Nicaraguan binder. We weren't having an earthquake, it's just me, apparently. Let's see if I can get that to stop doing that. Binder and filler, the Nicaraguan is. And the, this is not good. Hold that thought. Not bad. That's nice tasting there. Bad at all there. Ecuadorian Habano wrapper. I do have matches just in case, but try not to use those outside because they don't work so well. Not today's matches, they're like this small and they burn like that. So anyway, Savinelli started, obviously, with pipes a long time ago, back in the late 1800s, and they were very well known for their perfect pipe making, really, for their unbelievable quality for pipes. This is a very nice, thick ring gauge. You know me, I'm a pretty big ring gauge guy when it comes to cigars, because you have the whole, so many layers of tobacco in there that can give you a lot of flavor. This one doesn't have any spice going to it. Right now, a little Pepsi commercial apparently for them, but I'm thirsty. I could have just brought a bottle of water, but you know, like a little bit of sugar, a little bit of taste every now and then. It's beautiful out here at the Tapatio Resort. This is just a piece of it. There's an actual restaurant right back in here. The whole resort is huge. A lot of them are out here. Might give you a shot of the view. The place I live at is literally 5 minutes down the road. I can actually see it from up here because I am elevated. And which is pretty nice when I'm going to be finding a nice bike here someday. And when I do, I'm going to ride up here quite often because it'd be a good little training exercise, I think. I am taking a chance on using my camera again, the one I bought specifically to do this show with. And I had problems with being able to hear myself. And so I'm trying it again. I'm learning some of the software to, embed wording and stuff like that, instead of using YouTube, because YouTube, for some reason, when you do it, it doesn't show up on anything other than when you're on YouTube on a computer. Not exactly understanding that, so doing it myself now, and it's taking me a little bit of time, but we're figuring it out. This baby here at one point was rated a 92 in the Cigar Aficionado and also a 92 in the Cigar Insider, so it's very, they ended up getting into the cigar business after a while, after many years, and they had a lot of different contacts as far as, you know, really good cigar producers and blending, you know. So they wanted obviously the highest quality that they could make, that they wanted to do. This one was made with this is from the Oliva cigar company here. Their first one that they ended up putting out, they had the, I believe you've heard of them, Fuente, Arturo Fuente, made their cigars and rolled them, blended them. So now this one was done by Oliva, and pretty nice, to say the least. Really, let me get some flavor here. What it might be, I can taste. Some almond, a little bit of almond. Cedar, got definitely some cedar tones in there. I can really taste some tobacco. I laughed at the wrong time. Almost choked myself there. It is fairly warm out today. It is not as warm as it's been, though. It's probably right in the low hundreds right now, which honestly, not bad. Not bad at all, considering it's been like 111 and stuff. It is still fairly early. It's 12 o'clock. But, you know. Out here in Arizona, it stays hot. So, it being in the low hundreds, it's very nice. I really wanted to go someplace different today. So, this is not bad. A little new setting, I guess. And I want to try to keep doing that. Every few shows at least, go to a different resort. The resorts out here are just outstanding. They're beautiful. Obviously, they make them that way for a reason. But it just kind of, I don't know, gives a little different taste to the show. I was going to put on music again, but there's some birds singing, so that's pretty good. Some good singing from the birds. Seems to be burning pretty decent. The burn line, it looks fairly nice and thin, not really black, a little bit. So that's usually with the nice aging of the tobacco. I really haven't had. Savinelli obviously been around for quite some time, I've got you propped on top of my car, and I'm leaning against my car, so had to switch it up a little bit there. Should have probably brought a chair, you know, but I didn't, and that's okay. The Savinelli cigars have been around a long time. I remember stocking them when I was the manager of the cigar store in Colorado, which doesn't exist anymore, to keep bringing that one up. And never really tried them, you know. I was always trying the Arturo Fuentes, the Avos, all those others. And so this is really my first Savinelli, and so far, so good. Really not too bad. I actually bought this at a different cigar store last night. My favorite one, Ambassador's Fine Cigars, were closed. They closed about 5 last night, so I missed that. Didn't want to go to the same one I went to, the Magnum's place, because I had just been there. There's another one right down my street, so I went to that one. And real small little humidor and stuff, but it's guys running it know what they're doing, and that's always nice. They have a little place to sit, little TV there. decent little place. They carried some nice ones, and I'll be trying. I bought two there last night, specifically for the show. This is one of them, and I have another one that I'll do later on this week. So I'm trying to go to different cigar stores as well, you know, see how it all works out. So I would go to that one. It's not my favorite. Let's just say that. It's a very cute little place. Goodfellow Cigars, I believe. Goodfella or Goodfellow. One of those. And decent little place and stuff like that. But, you know, I'll probably go there every now and then, grab a cigar. But it won't be my mainstay, that's for sure. This is very nice. Now, since I do have the software going, the movie making software going pretty decent now, I'm figuring it out. This review, I will definitely have a whole little thing come up as far as how this cigar finishes. So far, it's holding a nice ash. Gotta like that. Pretty white ash as well. The construction feels real nice. You can tell the, you know, nice and solid all the way through. Draw is perfect. It's honestly a perfect draw. It really has just enough resistance. Feel it going through the tobacco, but not too much, so you don't have to labor just to smoke your cigar. Really don't like that. I also don't like a cigar where it feels like you're sucking through a straw, because then that's just, it's too light, you know? Very nice. Very beautiful day. I'm very lucky right now to be able to do this. I know that there are a lot of countries and a lot of different places that having quite a bit of problems, and you know, just happen to be in a good place. So that's very good. Hope you are too. Hope you're enjoying some cigars, some friendships, and stuff like that. Commenting, saying hi, whatever you want. Don't forget, if you ever get on Twitter, I'm on Twitter, at Cigar Review TV. And if you ever want to contact me, you can contact me through email if you want. Damon@cigarreviewtv.com. Damon is spelled D-A-M-O-N. And it's also on Facebook now. I just made a Facebook page. I wasn't going to, but I figured why not, because I know that there are quite a few people on Facebook and not on Twitter. So I'm on Facebook. Cigar Review TV is on Facebook, and you can look me up there. Like the page if you like. You don't have to, but if you'd like to, you can. That'd be great. I'd love you to. Spread that baby around. I've got two people liking it right now. One of them's me. So far, this baby, it's proven pretty good. Oh, paid $8.50 for it, which really is quite reasonable nowadays for a nice cigar. And this is definitely a nice cigar. Really decent flavors flowing. Obviously, it's now starting to kind of get into the roasted nuts / vegetable section. It's kind of what a lot of cigars for me end up going into, is kind of like a rawness and then into a roasted type thing. And then depending on how it finishes up, sometimes, you know, burned, sometimes still just nice and roasted. But that, like, with me liking these big ring gauges, I like the guillotine cutter, because if I have just like a punch, you know, a punch cutter or just a slit thing, a lot of buildup, you know, of the the different nicotine in there and gets really acidic in my mouth. So that's why I like the guillotine cutter the best. So just in case you wondered that, I do have a punch cutter, but I only use it in kind of an emergency when I forget everything else. So, and there's actually one, if I remember right, in my lighter, which is kind of nice. So just right there, that's perfect as long as my lighter's with me and it's lighting something. There we go. Well, that's going to do it for today, I believe. I'm going to just relax and enjoy the rest of this up here. Oh, I'm going to show you around real quick after this, and then that'll be it. But thank you very much for watching. I really appreciate it. I really hope your day is well. And it's beautiful out here. Just a few clouds in the sky. So take care of yourself. I'm going to show you around. This is going up into that restaurant. Just saw somebody watching me. They got a free show. How about that, huh? Of course, you always got to have the palm trees. And then my place is out right down in there, which is pretty nice to be that close. Goes all the way around like that. So I'll leave you with the view. Thank you for watching, and I will see you soon.